Please stand. Y'all may be seated. Dearly beloved, we've come together in the presence of God to witness and to bless the marriage of Eric and Alana in holy matrimony. The binding covenant of marriage was established by God in creation, and our Lord Jesus Christ adorned this manner of life by his presence and first miracle at a wedding in Cana in Galilee. Signifies to us the mystery of the union between Christ and his church. And Holy Scripture commends it to be honored among all people. The union of husband and wife and heart, body, and mind is intended by God for their mutual joy, for the help and comfort given one another in prosperity and adversity, and when it is God's will for the procreation of children and their nurture in the knowledge and love of the Lord. Therefore, marriage is not to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, deliberately, and in accordance with the purposes for which it was instituted by God. Into this union, Alana and Eric now come to be joined. If any of you can show just cause why they may not lawfully be married, you may speak now or forever hold your peace. Good. Before God in this congregation, I ask you to affirm your willingness to enter this covenant of marriage and to share all the joys and sorrows of this new relationship, whatever the future may hold. Eric, will you have Alana to be your wife, and will you love her faithfully as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Good. Alana, will you have Eric to be your husband, and will you love him faithfully as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Good. Share with you some words of scripture and then a few thoughts. I want you to listen to these words, because although Paul didn't write them about marriage, he sure could have. According to the Apostle Paul, as God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, meekness, and patience. Bear with one another, and if any has a complaint against another, forgive each other, just as the Lord has forgiven you, so you must also forgive. Above all, clothe yourselves with love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. And let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, to which you were indeed called into the one body. And be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly, teach and admonish one another in all wisdom, and with gratitude in your hearts, sing psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs to God. And whatever you do in word or deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. Amen. Right? You have done it. Not that there were some obstacles in the way, right, that y'all have overcome. And here you are, probably looking as good as you have, maybe in years and years and years. She always looks a good answer. My goodness gracious. And as anyone married will tell you, and I'm looking, I'm sure, at some married folks here, right? Today is the hardest day of your marriage. After today, it all gets easy. Right? Married people, right? Yeah, they're laughing. You know why they're laughing? Because they know it ain't true. As a matter of fact, even given all the stuff that's happened in the last, you know, few months, this is actually the easiest day of your marriage. It's tomorrow that gets challenging, and the next day, and the next day. And, you know, I'll tell you, sometimes it's not the big things that trip us up. You know, the big things we can handle because we're braced for them. It's the little stuff that kind of can throw us off. And I'm going to give you a couple of examples of little things. Now, Eric, what is it that you do for a living?
I'm an EMT, and I work maintenance.
EMT, that's right. You work all the time. That's right, because the only time you could call me is between jobs.
Usually.
Right, yeah. So you're doing maintenance, EMT work, so it's low stress. No, you get home, okay? You finally get home, right? And when you get home, you ever have a hard day when you're tired? Yeah, okay. You get home, you're really tired. What is it that you want to do when you're really tired?
Go to bed.
Okay, now the right answer was spend time with Alana. But that's okay. You did do the good. You did say she always looks good earlier. And that's going to win you points.
She's not usually there.
Okay. Well, you want to go to bed, right? And just sleep. Now, so you're there. Your eyelids are getting heavy. You're ready to drift off. And then Alana comes in and says words that puts fear into every husband. She says, Eric, and that's the way she says it, Eric, we need to, thank you very much, we need a man who's been there, we need to talk. And you know what that means? You won't be sleeping anytime soon. You know what you'll be doing? Because we need to talk, you know what you'll be doing? Listening. And then apologizing. A lot. That's one of those little things I'm talking about trip you up. And Alana, when you first met, how long have you known Derek?
2 years today.
2 years today? That's amazing.
Well, we dated 2 years today.
Yes, you started dating. When you first went out with it, did you think, man, this is the guy I'm going to marry? No, it probably
wouldn't even get in the truck.
She wouldn't get in the truck? Yeah, probably not. And you remember when you started dating 2 years ago? Eric, those cute little habits that Eric has, mm-hmm. that you were sure that if you could work on him for 2 years, you could change. What have you learned after 2 years?
You can't
change them, right? Now, see, these are the little things I'm talking about. And these are the things that can trip us up. And that's why I read the scripture I read. Because I'll tell you, if every single day, and I'm talking about every day, you make the decision to be patient and kind with one another. If you make the decision to listen when you'd rather be talking and to put yourself second instead of being first. And if you make the decision, and I'm telling you it's a decision, that you make the decision that you are going to love this person even though that particular morning you don't like them much, but you are going to love them. And love is an action and a decision. I'm telling you, not only will you be able to deal with these little speed bumps, you'll be able to handle the big things like they were nothing. Amen. Let's have a word of prayer. Lord God, you are present with us because you're with us all the time and your spirit flows around and through us. We ask that you bless Eric and Alana as they pledge their lives to each other, that their love may continue to grow and be a true reflection of your love for us all. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Now, Alana, would you do me a favor? Would you pass your flowers over? Thank you. And join hands. Would you all join hands? And Eric, what I want you to look as deeply as you can into Alana's eyes. As deeply as you can. And I want you to repeat these words after me. I, Eric, take you, Alana.
I, Eric, take you, Alana.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part.
Till death us do part.
According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God's holy ordinance.
And thereto I pledge myself truly.
And thereto I pledge myself truly.
With all my heart.
With all my heart.
Good. Now, Alana, I want you to look as deeply in, as you can into Eric's eyes and repeat after me. I, Alana, take you, Eric.
I, Alana, take you, Eric.
As my wedded husband.
As my wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part.
Till death us do part.
According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God's holy ordinance.
And thereto I pledge myself truly.
And thereto I pledge myself truly.
With all my heart.
With all my heart.
Thank you. Rings.
We lost it. We're fighting.
Now, Eric, would you put Alana's ring on the fourth finger of her left hand and repeat after me? I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a sign of my promise.
As a sign of my promise.
Good. And Alana, would you put Eric's ring on the fourth finger of his left hand and repeat after me? I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a sign of my promise.
As a sign of my promise.
Good. Let's have a word of prayer together. Eternal God, your love is the source of all good things. Right now, we pray that the knowledge of your love may inspire this union that's now begun. Grant that Alana and Eric, who dedicated themselves to one another in your name, grant that they may live in harmony and true companionship throughout their life together, seeking one another's welfare, bearing one another's burdens, and sharing one another's joys. Give them the resources to live without the fear of poverty and grant them joy in their home. Father, keep them true to the faith in which this marriage has begun, that they may always walk within the light and love of Christ, strengthened by the Spirit against all temptation. And when mortal life is over, bring them in your mercy to the joy of that life, which shall have no ending in the kingdom of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Since you have now pledged yourself to one another in the covenant of marriage and made your declaration before God and these witnesses, I pronounce you to be, should be a drum roll, I now pronounce you to be husband and wife in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. What God has joined together, let no one separate. As God's own, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, and patience, forgiving each other as the Lord has forgiven you, and crown all these things with love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. Amen. Eric, you may now kiss your wife. And that is a kiss. Turn and face your guests. It is with great pleasure that I introduce for the very first time in human history, Mr. and Mrs. Eric Falk. Please stand.
candlelight for any